Tinamwana muke labda, se yo mama, la kinimwana muke, niyeye kabisa. Tinamwana muke labda, se yo mama, la kinimwana muke, niyeye kabisa.
Yeah. I always dreamed of having a fairy tale life with a white house, picket fence and two kids. But the older I get, the more I realize that getting what I want is harder than it seems. Thank you so much. Yes. Thank you so much for your support.
Ava, tell us more about your book.
Well, it's my first venture into the non-traditional publishing world.
Well, let's be clear. It's been reported that you were recently dropped from your publishing company. Is that true?
It was a mutual parting of ways.
Okay, I will say a pardon that's actually working out in your favor. Your book is everywhere.
And I am so grateful. You know, I just want to help Black women who are suffering from infertility. That's what the book is about. It chronicles my own journey trying to conceive through a series of essays.
Well, a journey that you say a lot of Black women are suffering in silence. Why is that?
Honestly, because of shame. It's something that transcends our entire culture. You know, from suicide to sexual abuse to depression and mental illness, those are just things Black folks don't talk about. But we can't keep masquerading our feelings.
Okay, now that's ironic because I'm looking at your cover and you're clearly holding a mask. You want to explain that?
Well, the mask is symbolizing something bigger. It includes our ancestors. I realize that there are so many different tales about this one mask, and they trace all the way back to Tanzania. And there was one story in particular about a male dancer who pretends to be a young woman. Through dance, he mimes the various parts of a relationship. But it's all just a game of charades, right? Because you still have to take the mask off, and once you do, that's when the real story begins.
Ooh, okay. That's pretty heavy. Let's take some questions from the audience. You.
Ava, first, I want to say that I love you and thank you for bearing your soul in this book.
I love you too.
I do wonder about your path, though. I mean, you were single, writing romance novels, wishing for a man, but now you're married and you still don't have that fairy tale ending that you once wrote about. I mean, do you feel cursed?
Every goddamn day.
No, I just pray and leave it up to God. That's all I can do.
Okay. All right, you, go ahead.
I read your book twice, and without it, I'd probably be in a nut house by now, because it's so hard to get people to understand what this feels like. And like you, my husband and I have been trying for a while. I often feel alone, because he has a daughter from a previous relationship, and sometimes I feel jealous that they spend time together without me. Do you ever feel the same way about your stepson?
No. I love my stepson, and my husband always makes sure to involve me in everything they do.
Mm. All right, let's take some questions from the men. Go ahead, sir.
I have two questions. Your book is called Black Girl's Guide to Fertility, but are you even Black?
No. First off, you can't talk to my wife like that.
Baby.
Man.
sir. To answer your question, yes, I am Black. You know, I think it's really important for people, especially Black folks, to recognize that we come in many different shades. That's what makes us so unique.
If you say so. And my second question.
Sir, that's enough.
My wife said that you took to Instagram this morning and shared your recent failed IUI cycle and claim that you are doing fine. But you do not look fine to me.
Are you jealous?
Are you even Black?
Okay, you gotta win more than one to be on a winning streak.
Here, right there.
All right, you blocked me. It's all good. You trying to sneak one on?
No.
I see you. What do you see for? You don't see four?
Is she okay? 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 2, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 3, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Take it from the turns.
Not look fine to me,
but you do not look fine to me.
No.